Hi there. Have a seat, make yourself comfy. Well, the owl's off on another jaunt. If you don't know much about today's subject, well, stick around for 10 to 15 minutes. I think we'll both learn something. I hope to make it interesting. Without further ado, shall we go? Now then, would this be a clue? Well, kind of, if you know this place already. So, this time we're heading towards Ripley and Jacksdale, to the Cromford Canal at Codnor Park. There have been many fine blogs, vlogs and YouTube videos about this canal, and they will tell you in far more detail than this one about its entire 14.5-mile course, which was built in 1794 for the purpose of joining Cromford with the Erewash Canal at Langley Mill. This video, however, is firmly aimed at the often overlooked section between the eastern entrance of the Butterley Tunnel and the recently restored Humpy Bridge. This is a distance of a mere 1.5 miles, which includes the arm to Pinxton and which is packed to the gunwales with history. The Butterley Tunnel is situated beneath the Butterley Reservoir, which was built to feed the canal with water from above. So that water from the Erewash River wasn't used by the canal during the week, which would have deprived the various commercial concerns along its length of water flow. While the Erewash powered industry during the week, at the weekends it filled the reservoir in readiness for the week ahead. When first opened, the tunnel was 1.3 miles long and one of the world's three longest canal tunnels, even boasting a wharf within it which was used by the Butterley Company to load canal boats. There's also a small spur inside the tunnel which leads to the Butterley Car Pit. In a masterstroke of irony, it was mining subsidence which was responsible for closing the tunnel at the opening of the 20th century. Okay, here we are. This is what all the fuss has been about. This is the eastern portal to the Butterley Tunnel, and it's where we're starting our walk from. We're heading down there for about 1.5 miles to a place known as the Humpy Bridge, and in between, I hope you'll find it interesting. Come with me. Alongside the eastern portal lies the Golden Valley Light Railway. This line is of 2-foot gauge and runs for almost 1 mile along the trackbed of the Butterley Works Plateway. This was an industrial line built at the Butterley Works to carry goods to the wharf at Ironville. After leaving the eastern tunnel mouth, one of the first points of interest is a small, but strongly built, pedestrian bridge, which leads from a gap between the cottages on your left, across the canal to, well, apparently nowhere. This was built to allow the people who lived in the cottages to gain access to their allotments, which used to be on the other side of the canal. The allotments are now abandoned, the space where they used to be being occupied by a part of the Golden Valley Equestrian Centre. A short but very pleasing tree-lined walk will lead you past the now disused canal, its sections of water and wildlife, then later over a bridge, and eventually to the Codnor Park Reservoir. The reservoir was originally built to fill the Cromford Canal and the lock system on it, one of three such reservoirs built at the time: the Butterley, the Codnor Park, both of which still exist, and the Butterley Park Reservoir, which was filled in during 1935 and is now a part of the Midland Railway Centre. Codnor Park Reservoir is now a thriving nature reserve, boasting many species of great interest, many of which are under threat in other areas, and many more are well-known old favourites. At the far eastern end of the reservoir there is a dam and the flood relief scheme from the 1980s. Immediately after that there is a bridge. This bridge used to take the towpath over the Pinxton arm of the canal, which at one time went as far as the Pinxton pottery and no less than seven Portland collieries, which it served until the tramway was opened by the Butterley Ironworks to convey the coal to the site of the Portland wharf at Jacksdale. More of that later on. Later, in 1819, the Mansfield Railway was built to do the same job. As its course progresses, the now abandoned Pinxton Arm passes through Ironville, past the houses and the church, under a plethora of bridges, through woods and spinneys, past industrial estates and under the old Ambergate and Piebridge branch line, which is now the Midland Railway Centre at Butterley, and ultimately on to Pinxton Wharf. However, once back to the original track of the Cromford Canal, there's much history and not an inconsiderable amount of nature. Leaving the reservoir behind, the Cromford Canal continues to wind through Ironville and Jacksdale, passing under numerous bridges, alongside several locks and some impressive buildings, before passing the site of the Butterley Ironworks Codnor Park facility. All the time reminding us that when we build something that will last for an eternity, it's actually only temporary, as nature will take back what is and always has been hers. Many missing locks, often with almost dry watercourses, drive this point home, especially so as they are now wildlife paradises for insects, birds and small mammals, where once there was industrial fervour and pollution. Boats queuing, smoke emanating from the coal-fired chimneys, while the nearby ironworks darkened the skies with soot-laden smoke from the industrial processes occurring on the site. It has most definitely changed in the ensuing years into what we see today, an almost idyllic nature reserve which is a pleasure to walk along, due in no small part to the volunteers who work so hard on this historic site. The site of the old Butterley Works is now not only abandoned, but totally flattened and quickly going back to nature. There are few clues that this was ever a major site for the production of iron. However, many notable buildings owe their existence to this site. Indeed, the span for the train shed at St Pancras Station in London, steel for Portsmouth Spinnaker Tower and metal for many other landmarks, both architectural and historic, originated here. As we come to the end of this section of the canal, there is a bridge which spans the overflow into the Erewash River. As this bridge is approached, a boardwalk is to be seen crossing the canal if the water is low enough. This is roughly beneath where the previously mentioned tramway passed over, and clues like bridge abutments and anchor points may still be seen. In fact, the path of the old tramway is still plainly visible, heading off northeast towards the co-op. It now forms the route of a few of the footpaths in the area. Once you get to the Humpy Bridge, a change in the colour of the stonework signifies where recent repairs have been made, using methods in keeping with its construction, to restore the bridge to its original form after there was some damage caused to the structure. Some of the rarer animals which call this home are water voles. Also, there is a healthy population of kingfishers and some native white crayfish in the water. Well, that's it for this time. I'm off to have a rest and to think about my next project. If you're interested in any further information, please see the links in the description and feel free to look at the other videos on my channel. If you enjoyed this, then please like and subscribe. A thumbs up on the YouTube channel would also be greatly appreciated. Have fun, people. So you got here before me. Well done. Well, a mile and a half later, that's it. This is what it's all about. This is the Humpy Bridge. Well, I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I have. Ruby and I, well, we're off to do a little bit more. So we'll catch you next time, hopefully. Till then, stay safe. Bye. Go on, Ruby.